follow my lead. Let's go. You be not giving! after almost 80,000 years.
Jesus, Roberts! Have you gone mad?
Quite the contrary, Edward. These wags would have gone mad at seeing what lies beyond this gate. But you... I suspect you're made of sterner stuff. Now, pick up that chest and carry it hither. Dirty and decrepit. Not quite as I remember, but it has been over 80 millennia.
Ah, rot. That's impossible.
Step as if on thin ice, Captain. I must say I'm quite taken by this new vocation of mine, and it may amuse you to know that I have authored my own articles of conduct.
A creed of your own, eh?
To keep the peace, yes. I forbid all gambling upon the deck, for instance, for it leads to more conflict than camaraderie. Desertion during battle is forbidden. And I require that all men keep their pieces and cutlasses clean and fit for service at all times.
Look at this place.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Aye. Like something out of a fairy tale, or one of them old poems.
There were many stories about this place once. Tales that turned into rumors and again into legend. The inevitable process of facts becoming fictions before fading away in time.
More blood vials.
Yes. These cubes contain the blood of an old and ancient people. A wonderful race led by them.
The more you talk, man, the less I understand.
I don't expect you to. Only remember this. The blood in those vials is not worth a single real to anyone. It may be again one day, but not in this. Here we are. Place the chest just there.
What's that noise?
Ah, yes. A security measure. Just a moment. There we are.
So what is this place?
Think of it as a large spyglass, such as we sailors carry. A device capable of seeing great distances.
This is bloody witchcraft.
No, this is Mr. Jack Rackham, somewhere in the world at this moment.
NASA? Well, this is happening right now. We're seeing through his eyes.
I don't know, Jim. I haven't the faintest idea how to pilot a ship. That ain't work a woman does.
Tosh! I've seen a score of ladies who can reef a sail and spin a capstan.
And would you teach me to fight? With a cutlass, like? And maybe handle a pistol?
All that and more. But you have to want it and work for it. There's no stumbling into true success.
Oi! Lad! That's my lasso making love to! You lay off! Or I'll catch
you. Up your ass, Rackham. Lad's the last thing you should be calling me.
Oh, is that right, is it? Lad?
A curious bunch. Let's try another. Governor Woods Rogers.
You have a bold idea, but I must think it carefully through.
A simple pledge of loyalty is all you need suggest to the House of Commons. An oath, a gesture, and a simple ceremonial dram of blood taken from the finger. That's all.
The ministers may give me trouble, but it should be easy enough to convince the House of Lords. They do adore an excess of pomp and circumstance.
Exactly. Tell them it's a show of fealty to the king against those revolting Jacobites.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, these Templars.
The crucial detail is the blood. You must get a sample from each man. We want to be ready when we find the observatory.
Agreed.
A precious tool, you see. Sorcery, that's what it is.
Not so! Every mechanism that gives this device its light is a true and physical thing. Ancient, yes, but nothing supernatural or strange.
We'll be masters of the ocean with that.
Oh, such ambition. There is nothing in my code about loyalty, boy. You played your role, but our partnership is done!
You're a dead man, Roberts!
jackdaws flown, Edward. Eh? That's the beauty of a democracy. The many outvote the one. Oh, you could sail with me, but with a temper as hot as yours, I fear you'd burn us all to cinders. Luckily, I know the king's bounty on your head is a large one, and I intend to collect. Have you ever seen the inside of a Jamaican prison, boy? Have you?
That'll pass. It's the Midazolam. I'm sorry about this, but we've had so many security breaches, we were forced to take drastic action. And Olivier is missing. He left for Chicago 2 days ago, but no one's seen him since. I know this seems excessive, but with our high-level security clearance, we have an obligation to our shareholders. Rest assured, we will compensate you when the hacker is found. So get some rest, okay? And if you're up to it, maybe capture some more footage? You're doing amazing work. I can't wait to show you the work we've been doing with your stuff. Take care.
Tossed you in the bunker. Nice. Those Templars upstairs aren't taking any chances. I think we need to erase all the dirt they might have on you. Did you hear that? I think I just gave you level 3 security clearance. Now, head to the security room and use the cameras to watch the door to the server farm. Unfortunately, Melanie's in there now. So when I escort her out, that's when you make your move. I'd wipe these servers myself, but as the head of IT, I'd be a suspect. It has to be someone they've already locked up. Hey, you know you're supposed to be locked up, right? Going back upstairs ain't a good plan.
Down here by yourself, Miss LeMay. My team will handle the investigation.
But you need an extra set of eyes on this thing, John. We don't even know when the hacker's broken. It could take weeks to go through this data.
One, at most.
Still too long. I can't keep my team locked up for a week.
Legally, you can. It's what they signed up for, even if they didn't read their contracts.
Yes, of course. I just hate the idea. So what's the next step?
My team is processing the data now. We'll start sifting through it tonight. Scout's honor. Buffy's on me, okay?
Coffee stand. Find a server containing a network log. Since I have a record of each and every one of your hacks, we'll just search for the timestamps on those and turn that data into something harmless. Easy as that. Here we are. Beautiful. I'll update your communicator one more time. A little program I cooked up just for this purpose. There we go. I think that worked. Try it out.
The dawn of the deadly 18th century. Rogues and sailors band together to live their lives by the sword. With no laws or morals, no gods, and no fear. Only betrayal, mutiny, cruelty, and debauchery. There is plunder to be found on golden beaches. Will you risk life and soul to fight the pirates of nightmares? Benjamin Hornigold, Calico Jack, Charles Vane, and Blackbeard?
Cipher. Feel, but hardly touch. Signal is still too weak, and I am spread thin. Unfocused, like static in fog. Lingering in networks and nodes, the nervous system of the world.
Can you hear?
Perhaps the temple was opened too soon, but this was not by choice. The cataclysm pushed all doubt aside. We bless poor Desmond, who gave his life so that you, the children of our labors, would live on. To fulfill your purpose in ours, in mine. But now is not the time. My strength is not sufficient to inhabit an organic vessel. There is more work to do, more samples to acquire, more artifacts to find before my will can attain.
What's happening? Tell me!
Make me whole again, my children, my instruments. Bring me forth to fulfill your purpose.
Tell me! No, no, no! Something's wrong! God damn it! She should be here! Now! Living in that goddamned head of yours! Fuck, 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 fuck! Why did she spare you? Why are you still here?
Charges, sir. I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take to certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother. Married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastard, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
Philip, Kenmore, Conway.
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumor going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. And back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
Jeez.
Quiet!
As shit detail as ever was.
Oi! Oi! Stop that! This is a warning!
Oi!
Oi!
Water.
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you.
Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Thank you.
You! Stop there! Clear shot.
Discovered and brought here. Didn't hear what happened after.
Don't buy!
Best of luck to you, mate. I wish we'd parted as friends.
Mary, it's me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh!
Oh! Oh! I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent.
Can you walk? Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
I can't.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Don't die on my account. Go.
This is such a pain in the ass. Damn it. You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, Kim. What's happened to Mary? What's wrong?
Is she gone? You do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward.
Thank you. Bring a bottle.
I see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in one-fifth the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll sweeten you, maggot. I'll cut you down! Calm, little puppy. And slink back to your kennel. You haven't the metal for my brand of madness.
Robert!
Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Raise a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Above a shepherd's field, but swooped down on powerful wings to seize a grazing lamb and carry it off to her. Flying close by, a jackdaw saw the deed, and it filled his head with the idea that he too was just as strong and capable. So, with a great flapping and rustling of feathers, the jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the coat of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal, for his size and strength were not up to the task. And even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram hardly noticed he was there. Nearby, just across the field, the shepherd saw the fluttering bird and was quite amused. Running up, he captured the jackdaw and clipped its wings. That evening, he gave the jackdaw to his children as a gift. "What an odd little bird this is, father," they laughed and shouted. "What do you call him?" "This is a jackdaw," the father said. "But if you should ask him, he would claim to be an eagle."
"No more than 2 years! You promised me!"
"You left! When I needed you the most!"
"But you had me! What keeps you wondering? Do I not make you happy?"
"I'm so close, Caroline! Please, just let me do this!
Is everything you do out of spite, Edward?"
"It's not spite that's driving me, Mary! It's courage!"
"Courage for what, man? There's no one left in your life to care!"
"Goddamn war! I can handle this!"
"You're loud! Always tearing down when you could be building things up, or building yourself up if nothing else!"
"Just leave me be!"
"Change course, Edward! Change your bloody course before it's too late!"
Captain Kenway! You look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I should have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving?
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.
Just keep it with you,
Grish.
got to feel a demon.
Oh.
Thank you. Thank you. been knocking him up, sir!
Jesus, Addy, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable course. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain Kenway.
Mary. Before she died, she asked me to do good by her. To sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye. She told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why indeed?
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom. Not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edward I met here many years ago. So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Creo que puedo dar.
Janumuk awol yetel abishan. And once more, you have our thanks, Edward. You are welcome here.
Thank you, sir. I'll rest here for a time before setting out, if I may. How's her child?
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Edward.
I'm sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd now be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing, drinking, fighting.
You are a fighter, aye. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
True. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his lads weren't passed out in the hold from drink. Edward. Everyone's gone, right there. Mary, Bracken, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so. Rough as they were. Do you fear that too? All empty inside?
I do. Devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough, but how will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers, but Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. It might take months to find him.
Or years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, don't be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster! What's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bonny. Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads! We're sailing for Jamaica!
How does it feel to bark so loud?
I've barked louder, and to men twice as rough.
Attending bar at the old Avery, you mean?
Among other places. And I sailed with Mary in Rackham for a time, remember?
Of course.
Mary did most of the captaining, Jack did most of the drinking.
Did Mary... Did she ever tell you who it was that fathered her child?
It was a young fella. Sailed with us on that last voyage. Poor lad was killed fighting beside us. The only man not too drunk to stand up for himself.
There was so much about her I didn't know. I called her a friend.
Or was I one in return?
She thought the world of you, Edward. Have no worries about that.
Well, that's good to hear. Travers?
What tide brings you? You dress the part of an assassin, yet I don't know your face.
Name's Kenway. I'm here to warn you of a threat to your bureau.
Yes, I have noticed some suspicious men lurking about. I believe they work for a noted Templar called Upton. Could you eliminate him for me?
Oh, I may be persuaded. For a price. You wouldn't happen to know anything about a Templar key, would you?
I'm sure you may find it among Upton's men. If I tell you where they are.
You've got yourself a deal.
From his own smuggling operation.
Oh, I know. It sounds ridiculous. But a job's a job.
I suppose you're wrong. Away from his own smuggling operation.
I know. It sounds ridiculous. But a job's a job.
I suppose you're right. Smuggling from a smuggler. Hey, did you ever think about that word, smuggler? Rather funny, ain't it?
Whoever thinks about words?
Well, not me, sir. But say. Agala.
You're right. It does have a kind of a funny ring to it.
Smuggler!
Here, wait, mate. Maybe we shouldn't be saying it quite so loud, though.
On account of it being smuggling?
Right.
Right.
They'll just be waiting for us when we get there.
Yes. This should be easy.
So we move the woods, then we go to the inn.
Oh, we should be so lucky.
Oh, look, there they are.
Hello.
All right, go.
I am Upton Travers, Bureau Leader.
What? Is Vance your...
My blood brother. We work together. And those were not Templars that you killed. They were my workers.
Don't blame me. Your brother ordered it.
Does he mean to usurp me?
I don't know, mate. I'm only after a Templar key.
A what? I need for you to tell me everything.
And why should I trust you?
Meet me at the Bureau, and I will show you.
Oh, bother.
My lovesick idiot of a brother has misled you.
Start from the start, mate.
Recently, our trade introduced us to a formidable woman. Jing Lang, a pirate from the farthest seas of the Orient.
Intriguing.
She and Vance quickly became inseparable.
Any reason he should have thought your men were spies?
Well, there is the treasure.
Oh?
A pirate sold us a map. We each kept half. Come. I will meet him now. If you follow with discretion, you may hear it for yourself. Follow me at a distance. If anyone sees you, tell them you are my bodyguard. There are thieves about who would stop at nothing to secure either half of the map.
Good day, my brother.
Good day, brother. If I may still call you that.
Why?
What else would you call me? Stranger, perhaps? I barely know you.
And if the whispers around town are to be believed, you would have me gone and done away.
Upton, come. You know better than to give it to gossip. Ness always too small. Local times turn everything to sentimental comedy.
It's a domestic tragedy I'm trying to avoid.
Well said, brother. No stronger bonds than family. Business. Goodness knows we have more than enough of that between us as well.
That is true, brother. That is very true. And what a business it is. I'm sure neither of us would ever do anything to our sentimentality.
Why? Now, no.
This pirate you pay is a blood! Any innocent!
day, brother. If I may still call you that.
Why? What else would you call me?
Stranger, perhaps? I barely knew you. And if the whispers around town are to be believed, you would have me gone and done away with.
Upton, calm. You know better than to give it to gossip. Ness always too small. Local tongues turn everything to sentimental comedy.
It's domestic tragedy I'm trying to avoid.
Well said, brother. No stronger bonds than family. Except business. Goodness knows we have more than enough of that between us as well.
That is true, brother. That is very true. And what a business it is. I'm sure neither of us would ever do anything to the palace.
Quiet. Now tell me. You brought it.
It? My half of the map, you mean?
The map. Of course, the map.
The map to the treasure. To our legacy.
The very one.
Good day, brother. I may still call you that.
Why? What else would you call me?
Stranger, perhaps? I barely know you anymore. And if the whispers around town are to be believed, you would have me gone and done away.
Upton, come. You know better than to get into gossip. Ness always too small. Local tongues turn everything to sentimental comedy.
It's domestic tragedy I'm trying to avoid.
Well said, brother. No stronger bonds than family. Except business. Goodness knows we have more than enough of that between us as well.
That is true, brother. That is very true. And what a business it is. I'm sure neither of us would ever do anything to upset the palace.
Quiet. Now tell me. You brought it.
It? My half of the map, you mean?
The map. Of course the map.
The map to the treasure. To our legacy.
That very one. I have mine. Where is yours?
That you know I feel. We must protect that treasure with utmost caution.
But for contrary, that map is our protection. Its treasure, our freedom.
All the more reason to keep it buried. Safe.
Have you no imagination? Can you not imagine the luxurious life that awaits us once we unearth its bounty?
I really don't think that.
Travers Estate Plantations. No more smuggling. No more organized men, no shippers, no tourists. Why not begin now?
Day, brother.
Perhaps? I barely knew you anymore.
And if the whispers around town are to be believed, you would have me gone and done away with.
Upton, calm. You know better than to give it to gossip. Ness always too small. Local tongues turn everything to sentimental comedy.
It's domestic tragedy I'm trying to avoid.
Well said, brother. No stronger bonds than family. Except business. Goodness knows we have more than enough of that between us as well.
That is true, brother. That is very true. And what a business it is. I'm sure neither of us would ever do anything to upset the palace.
What? Now tell me. You brought it.
It? My half of the map, you mean?
The map. Of course the map.
The map to the treasure. To our legacy.
That very one. I have mine. Where is yours?
Vance, you know I feel we must protect that treasure with utmost caution.
On the contrary, that map is our protection. Its treasure, our freedom.
All the more reason to keep it buried. Safe.
But have you no imagination? Can you not imagine the luxurious life that awaits us once we unearth its bounty?
I really don't think that...
The Travers Estate Plantations. No more smuggling. No more organizing men. No shipments. No risk. Why not begin now?
The plans. Are you sure your future will unfold so easily?
What do you mean? What do you imply?
I am not implying. I am merely asking. Do you really imagine the chief has pervaded my...
My order. You know we can't leave until I have it.
I'm taking care of it. Give me time.
More time? Your loyalty makes you soft. I think you're not man enough to see it through.
My flower. It's all but done. I've hired a man. In moments, Upton's life will be over.
Seems you could use a little help disappearing, friend.
It's all but done. Hire the men.
We'll see on it.
Am I true?
Just the other day, Edmund Miller in a convent found half dead in a ditch. It's still.
I just saved your life, mate.
Vance. He said he would kill me. I thought it was bluster. He is my brother. Despite what you told me, I thought it meant something.
You're safe for now. But perhaps a trip away from Nassau would do you some good.
Good God, man. What's happened to you?
I cannot go on anymore. My brother, a traitor, that woman, Templar. I have no family, no wife of my own. What is the point of living? Let them kill me.
You don't know what you're saying, mate. Let's get you someplace safe.
What's the point?
The point is, I want my key. So I need you alive. I need your information, so I need you sober.
You are my best friend. Come here, I'll kill you! What are you looking at?
Hey, you there with a sharp face. Who's that you see with my mom?
I said she's a lovely woman, inside and out.
Oh,
I thought everyone did. That's right, I said it.
I'll fix that boot. Don't Stokes talk to the boss.
Ladies, that bastard.
Not over there.
Church, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy... Mate, the Father, the Son, and the Holy... What's the third one again?
Let's just keep it moving, yeah?
The Father, the Son, and the... Let's keep it moving? No, that's not it.
What does it matter?
It doesn't matter. Nothing in this sour life does. Let's keep it moving. Keep it moving. Who are these creatures?
That's no way to flatter a lady.
They all look like...
That's it. Captain, mate, no! Guards! There are guards nearby.
Piss off!
They won't stand for this.
I said piss off! Oh, I need a piss. Oh, that's much better.
Stop that!
What? Why won't no one let me so much as take a piss?
Put it away!
I'm like a child.
Oi, this is sacred ground! I'll teach you to urinate.
I don't want to be like a child, Edward.
It's all right, mate.
Help me not be like a child.
You just need the drink to wear off. Are you safe here?
Safety is an illusion. But yes, I have friends to the open heart. What do you must be? Have I said anything
else? No, mate. You sound quite the scholar.
Betrayal makes one philosophical, don't it? Imagine a Templar. My brother to marry a Templar.
I doubt it'll come to that.
I'm so afraid for him. Oh, please help keep him safe.
Sober up, mate. We'll finish this in the morning.
You're a forever friend, Kenway.
Thank you.
looking better than last we met.
As I sobered up, I began to see it more clearly. Jing has led my brother astray and must be killed. Vance has also betrayed me. As an assassin, his treachery must be punished by death.
So either way, one of them has the Templar key. You're obviously distraught. Let me take care of it.
I will tell you where to find them.
We know you signed the articles, pirate!
Hey! You have the wrong man! Why do you hunt me? Have a gun!
Captain Kenway, just in time. I'll see you back aboard.
Yourself. A word.
Not worth the time.
There! Break every shit!
It takes one to know one.
Jin Lang, as I live and breathe.
I told him not to hire you. You traitor! I will not meet the same fate!
Imagine the Queen of Pirates, Jin Lang, defeated for a fake map. I have been arrogant.
Really?
Yes, I stole the real one, both halves. My husband has it.
Your husband?
Better man than these fools.
Now, what could I add to make it perfect?
Captain Kenway.
You have something for me?
The present whereabouts of the Templar Woods Rogers. He is attending a small political function, so do it clean.
The word is King George is calling Rogers back to London.
Aye, not happy with his progress in Nassau.
Still too many pirates roaming about from what I hear.
You'll need a disguise to fool the powderheads at this party. I suggest the visiting diplomat, Ruggero Ferraro. He's been on our list for some time.
Understood. Will you send this to England for me?
Aye. The ship leaves tomorrow.
Caroline Scott Kenway, Hawkins Lane, Bristol. Salve. Forgive the lateness of my arrival. I am Ruggero Ferraro.
Aye, Mr. Ferraro. Not a problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to my brief tenure as Governor of the Bahamas. For under my watch, no less than 300 avowed pirates took the King's pardon and swore fealty to the crown. And yet, for all my successes, His Majesty has seen fit to sack me and call me home to England. Brilliant! Got in Nassar to heal, by God, and this is the thanks I get! Unbelievable. Damn right you did, Rogers. And if it's a character witness you need back home, I'm glad you send her a letter in support.
I had my confidence. I still do.
Well, it's not a done deal by any means. When the King hears my complaints, I'm sure he'll come to a more sensible conclusion.
Not so. The meeting was adjourned before the motion could be tabled. Half the local businessmen simply stood up and retired.
And how is Mrs. Rogers these days?
I haven't the faintest idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We separated almost 5 years ago, and both our lives have been the better for it.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later. When the remainder of my reason has left me.
He was a privateer once. How is it you lack so much respect for sailors only trying to make their way in this world?
You couldn't possibly understand my motives, cretin! You have spent a whole lifetime dismantling everything that makes our civilization shine.
But I do understand. I've seen the observatory, and I know its power. You'd use that device to spy and blackmail and sabotage.
Yes. And yet all for a greater purpose. To ensure justice. To snuff out lies and to seek truth.
There's no man on Earth who needs that power.
Yet you suffer the Outlaw Roberts to use it.
No. I'm taking it back. And if you tell me where he is, I'll stop the man.
Here at the edge of a blade, I find a friend in you at last.
Principe. You mad bastard. Our best sources say Principe.
You! Stop! Stop!
That man there! Italian! He did it!
It's done.
Where now?
Grab your kit and pack well. We're sailing for Africa.
As it happens, I could use a man to help free some of my friends.
Slaves, you mean?
Brothers. Warriors. The hope of the Maroon.
Doesn't sound like my business, mate.
All I need is for you to mingle with your countrymen. Listen to hints for where my friends are held.
Fine. I'll see what I can do.
Be careful! Damn him! A mother come.
And then he dismissed me without pay. Drunkenness.
A legend of goodness.
All I had to do was escort that man north. No. South. No. North. Definitely north.
Towards the warehouse.
Right, the warehouse. That cat, he's a slave. He's in Bilbo's. Not like he's gonna get away.
Let's have another round. Think this through.
Are you lying? I just lost me job.
Example of, or some such.
Well, what did he do?
Does he need to do anything? Sometimes examples just have to be made.
Hey, now isn't that just the truth?
I still have several days to get over it. The last storm did a lot of damage in the rigging, but
but she will be filled in time.
Well, when I first got here, there were ruffians of the worst ilk sauntering about, giving everyone fits. Mercifully, they've gone.
A cargo of pelts, as usual. They're paying one.
It wouldn't take a year. The walls have ears, if you know what I mean.
Are we followed?
We must warn the others. You got the information I need, mate.
No! I've heard of your kind. Assassin, don't hurt me!
All I want to know is where this slave is. Do you know of anyone being held? Especially...
Please! Let me live! My wife and children!
Come on, then! Out with it!
Look near the windmill.
See? Was that so hard?
Found your men.
And I found where his brothers are kept. Help me release them.
No, mate. I've settled my debt. Meddling with slaves is none of my affair. I doubt there's even a Templar behind it all.
All affairs of freedom are assassins' affairs. What is your price?
What?
A man without principle must be moved by coin. How much do you need?
There is a key I'm looking for. Belongs to a set I've been stripping off Templars.
The Templar keys? I thought they'd been destroyed.
I'm not the only one who knows about them, then.
If we find it, it's yours.
You have a deal. Let's go get your friends.
What's this? Only survivor?
Only captive.
You didn't lose the battle.
How can we win when the dogs all up in the mountains? They just hide in caves and wait. See us coming every time.
I hope Commander Abraham knows what he's doing.
I've no doubt he'll win in the end. I'll follow him to my death.
You think you can escape us?
Thank you.
Hurry, to my bureau.
See, you'll end up as Bahuki. I can't be.
Go to the bureau. Must exercise caution today.
Thanks.
Meet me at the bureau.
Where to next?
That's enough work for one night. Or do you grow fond of it?
That's it. No Templar. What about the key?
The Templar did not show himself. You will have your key next time.
No, Anto, there is no next time.
When you discover your conscience, or admit how badly you want the key, there will be a next time. You returned. Have you brought your conscience?
I want my key.
Patience is a virtue.
Expecting company.
You may have your key sooner than you think. Help us defend the Bureau. The men we freed will help. Before the next wave. Advance! So many. We can handle this one-handed. Attack! The more of them you kill now, the less effective they will be in the next wave.
Hey, get him!
I'm glad you showed up when you did. I'm sorry I have no key to give you, but...
No, the key can wait. Whoever did this, I want to teach them a lesson.
The Templar's name is Kenneth Abraham. He's part of an ongoing war with the Maroons. But we have held strong and will not be defeated. Let me devise a plan. I have a plan, but it won't be easy. Ibrahim is well connected and his pockets are deep. But we have located a man in his inner circle. We will tail him until he reveals our target.
Let me bring him to his end.
Here he comes now.
Commander be in attendance tonight?
Yes. I was just speaking with him. He's here somewhere.
A trap was right under our noses the whole time.
I've never met a soldier as cunning as a Maroon. It's no mistake he's been harder to defeat than the weak who came before.
Keep them busy.
How many years have we fought? Your men in the mountains with no weapons to speak of, and my army resplendent. And yet you live, and I die.
You lack the conviction to win.
A pleasure. Vraiment.